Hello everyone and welcome back to the Keep Productive YouTube channel. On today's feature, we're taking a look at ClickUp versus Marvin. Now, these two applications, I would say, are fairly similar in ability. Marvin is a powerful task management application, doesn't really have a great amount of team abilities, but ClickUp also has this sort of solo plan that allows you to organize your time as a productivity resource. And I think these applications are fairly similar. Now, obviously, ClickUp is about to go through a big change. And I know a lot of people in the comments will be like, Francesco, why are you reviewing ClickUp 1.0 versus Marvin? And I would say to that is that I want to do a separate ClickUp 2.0 review. But if you want to find an upgrade to ClickUp 2.0 now, you just have to go to this Try ClickUp. I believe it should be available for a lot of people. But again, the experience, in my opinion, will get a lot better. Version 1 is still very much very simplistic, but I think it's a good opportunity to put these two head to head. So we're going to start off with, obviously, like the structure, the design, and then we're going to dive into some of the features that make the two applications different. So you guys should be sort of get a good idea by the end of this video about what application you should go with if you're looking at these two applications head to head. So guys, just before we dive in, a big thank you. This month in June 2019 here on Keep Productive, we are sponsored by Bear Notes. Now, Bear is a powerful writing and noting application for iOS and Mac, and it is a popular choice amongst writers and avid note takers, whether you're crafting your next blog post or a next theatrical masterpiece. Bear has features like markdown editing, hashtag note organization, a range of typographies, and it's a smashing option for writers and note takers alike. Now, recently they released a WordPress integration, allowing you to automatically post to WordPress, and they have some more features coming soon. You can download Bear for free today on iOS and Mac, and just get writing today, give it a go. And thanks again for Bear for sponsoring June 2019 here on Keep Productive. So guys, let's start with ClickUp 1.0. And as you can see here, this is the experience you land on when you have a personal account. Now, what I quite like about ClickUp is, to some extent, it is this traditional setup. So if you go up here in the top left-hand corner, I can select my me area. And my me area is essentially my only workspace. So that's quite handy. You can switch between team and me access, whereas on Marvin, you literally only have yourself to deal with. It's more of a solo productivity tool. But with ClickUp, if you, for example, started using this with you and your team and you were like, okay, I really like this, and me and my team can start using this, you can use it with both of the situations, which is really helpful. So I can go and switch between what's called spaces inside of here. You don't actually have spaces inside of your Marvin account. And up here, I can go ahead and add a new task. Now, what I quite like about the task abilities on ClickUp versus Marvin is that when you can start adding tasks and start clicking up commands, obviously, you get the ability to add a description, subtask, checklist, attachments. Now, if you go over to Marvin, for example, you do have the ability to do that. Now, I'm not saying it's not available. For example, if I were to go and start adding a task here, if I, for example, said, feed the dog, very simple task. If I click into that task, obviously I can find out the information. But if I want to go into a range of detail, if I go to edit, you obviously only get this on preview. So obviously there is an ability to change that, I believe, if you go to the folders area. So if you go down here to your master list, obviously you get a very similar structure to the likes of ClickUp. We created this one, obviously, in inbox, I think it was, feed the dog, there we go. And you can obviously go ahead and edit the task in a bit more detail than if you would, for example, you know, be able to organize it inside of the other one. But what I find is the level of complexity is a lot less inside of ClickUp, whereas this is much more, I think, difficult to understand as you get started. If you see here, I can add the same task, feed the dog. And I can obviously change the position, I can star it, I can change the due date, repeat the task, and change who's actually watching this one. If I go ahead and create it, obviously it's got a lot better sort of, I'd say, animation in terms of being able to add a task. I actually wrote feed the fog. But when you open up a task, what I think is sort of the killer feature is if, for example, you've got this as a project or it's just a simple task, you can go into this sort of full page view. What I quite like about that is you can change the dependencies, the tags, you can add descriptions, add this really advanced to-do list and attachments. Then you can have this commenting conversation, whether that's between yourself, just adding a few notes or commands for later, that's quite handy. Whereas inside of Marvin, apart from obviously being able to connect up with strategies, which is something we'll go into a bit more detail in a minute, there's not as much you can do when you click into the task. And that's probably because it's not as much of a project manager than the likes of ClickUp is. And as you can see here, this is much more of a substantial project management abilities. So if I go out of this, obviously I have the ability to create a task anytime. What's quite nice as well is I can shift this between projects and create as much detail as I want for the project. Whereas in Marvin, you don't actually have the really strong project management abilities. If I go to my master list down here, yes, I do have a few abilities to create, like I can coordinate my day, I can go to the smart list and create one. And I do have a range of different views, like I can obviously change the views in strategy, but it's not as substantial, I'd say, as when you're being able to coordinate views inside of ClickUp. So if I go here, I can obviously change this into a board layout, so I can obviously drag stuff between it, which is really helpful. And I can go to list view, which I was just on, and time view as well, which is a calendar-like view. Now, you do get this inside of your Marvin account. You can go and obviously coordinate the day ahead. But what's cool as well is once you get a few apps connected up, you can go, for example, to My Week and be able to coordinate the days and even move stuff between statuses like tomorrow morning and be able to organize that and even switch ahead, go a couple of weeks in advance. And that's a specific view that might help. Now, what I do like about Marvin is it's more of a traditional productivity setup to some extent. If I go over to the strategies area, I can add a bunch of different strategies. Now, if you haven't watched the Marvin review, this will all be explained. So if you haven't watched it, I will just be breezing over this. I'll include the link in the description to that full review. But as you can see here, you've got a range of different tools, anything from the prioritization to the time management. And with time management, I can click on and off different areas. For example, that agenda view that we saw is now gone. It goes to this sort of morning and sort of afternoon, evening view. Whereas if I went to strategies, scrolled down to agenda, clicked it on, it would come back. And I can also do things in the project management space, like for example, planning ahead. In here, if I click this one on, you can plan projects and tasks for each month and week. And that's quite easy to access. So you get it up here, down the bottom, the planning area. And as you can see here, you can do a month planner, which means you can load like your entire year ahead and be able to plan major projects, which is quite handy. So if you had tasks, you could obviously move them around. If you wanted to see it in week view, you can as well. So there are abilities. I'm not saying there aren't abilities, but in terms of the streamlined, more traditional sort of productivity tools, I'd say it would go to ClickUp in terms of the project management, but in terms of traditional methods, then I'd say Marvin has the sort of upper hand. You can do a range of things like time blocking, and you can even have a calendar. So for example, if I went out of this and I was like, I want to be able to organize everything on calendar, I can see the calendar appear in the bottom left-hand corner. So, once you've got active tasks and you want to be able to move them, you can actually coordinate that. So obviously, you do get to have a range of flexibilities, like the features aren't completely missing, but I think it's a lot easier to navigate that inside of your ClickUp account. Now, talking about this sort of modular setup, all you have to do to find your modular setup and what apps you want, you have to go to ClickUp Apps. Now, ClickUp Apps obviously gives you access to what you actually have selected on. And this is quite cool because it's very similar to the strategies area inside of Marvin. So if I go to strategies, you can see it's very much like a carbon copy. Whoever got there first, it's obviously a very beneficial feature, but you can actually select specific features to be available per workspace, which is quite nice. For example, you can have and select on multiple assignees, and disable them for certain areas, or like you can have it on, okay, I'll have it on for freelancing, for example, and switch it off for YouTube as well. Now you can have like things like time tracking, time estimates, tags, priorities, incomplete warnings, rescheduling dependencies, custom fields, which are actually very helpful. Like you should have them on. But again, this is something that I'd say they've got less of a selection. If I go to the ClickUps area, you can see here that there's 10. Like that is a good amount. But if you go over to the strategies area of Marvin, they're literally developing a new one pretty much monthly, from what I actually mentioned in my last review. And they correlate a lot more to personal productivity. So for example, like you can select things like mindset, review date, weekly, GTD type of stuff, and also hardcore productivity setups. Like it even relates to books, like Eat That Frog is a prioritization setup, and even Backburner and things like that. So you do get more of an ability to organize, what I'd say is definitely a lot different. Now, what I'd say is that inside of ClickUp, you don't actually like get this, I would say, focused productivity setup. It's much more of a personal project manager than a personal task manager. Okay, so in terms of features, let's touch on a few of the things that these applications do better and do worse than the other applications. So to start, I'd say Marvin is a great application for personal productivity. What I quite like is you've got this customized setup. They're really designed by you. But what I would say is it's very limited to the applications it's available on. I believe there's an iOS edition coming soon, but it's still only available pretty much on web. And it does have some limitations in terms of, for example, like some of the commenting abilities. And if you were to turn this into a project manager, it's not available because you don't have the team access. Now, what I love about Marvin is the strategies area. If you go to strategies, obviously you've got a range of ones here, but the things that I'd say are the killer abilities are the time management experiences. Being able to turn some of these on using the week scheduler and even smaller stuff like the ability to have a custom sidebar, some of the matrices that you can add, and also the way that you can break down your day using time blocking, and a few project management abilities. I think this is a powerhouse, especially if you're using it on your own. Now, when ClickUp, I think I like quite a few things, like the ability to create as many spaces as you like, be able to quick search using K, be able to jump around your account. It's pretty fast and pretty smooth. They have an iOS application, and they have a range of import and export abilities, as well as a host of integrations. If I go to the integrations, I could connect up with Slack, Zapier, and many more. And it can also go into like loads of different settings, like what users I have and also preferences for my team. Now, when it comes to pricing, the pricing is free. You get 100 megabyte storage and unlimited projects and spaces, which is pretty crazy and actually is a really good deal. I always say this to people who are looking for a really easy way to start project management, is this will get you going pretty fast. But obviously, if you want the membership plans, it's going to be about £4, about $5 per month on the annual pricing, and about $8-ish. I'm going to have to get the US pricing in the description below. That will give you, obviously, some abilities like the unlimited storage and also a range of like Google Drive and unlimited custom fields, unlimited goals, etc., and loads of guest access. Now, obviously, the pricing is very much different to the Marvin pricing. So I mentioned to you guys, it is $8 a month, and that's the yearly plan. If you want to go for the monthly plan, it's $12. But what I'd say is this is much more suitable if you're a solo entrepreneur or individual that's looking for very traditional task of management abilities to get you started. It's not going to be your, you know, really fine-tuned application. It's still very early days. But the reason I put it head-to-head against the likes of ClickUp is the fact that they have this sort of modular setup, like the ability to actually coordinate your tasks and projects really quite smoothly using a range of different methodologies. I would say, as a blanket statement after this feature, ClickUp is definitely worth your money if you're looking at it, and they don't even charge you to get set up. It's got better abilities when it comes to moving from a personal task management or personal project management to a team abilities, and I think it's got more features in terms of being available on lots of different devices, and also the reporting abilities much more advanced than the likes of Marvin. Sort of perfect for those who like to really poke and sort of use their system, like who are stick maybe really stringent on their time management abilities and want this application that they can design and utilize in a very different way to certain other applications. Now, I will point you guys towards my Marvin review because I go into much more detail showcasing all the features, and also my ClickUp review, but I will be reviewing ClickUp 2.0, which is going to probably succeed this very soon. Success be the successor of this application very soon and actually really take it a lot further. So guys, let me know what you thought of this review. This is actually my first sort of switch between the applications and talk about them. If you want a more detailed review, please do let me know. If you want me to do a blog post on this, let me know. Please feel free to leave any comments below. I'm always learning about the way I can do videos better, so please, of course, comment. But it'd be great to have you subscribe if you're brand new. I'm always doing videos about productivity software, so if you want to join us there, feel free to. But anyway, guys, a big thank you. Make sure to have a great week. Keep productive, and I'll see you guys super duper soon. Cheers, everyone.